March 3rd and 4th, Wednesday and Thursday, the sun is in Pisces and the moon is in Scorpio. So as an astrologer, if you've studied with me, Pisces water, Scorpio water, when two planets are in the same element, effortless. Pisces wants to be quiet, wants to feel, doesn't want to be pushed, wants to even be left alone at times, wants to be super creative in their own creative process. The moon in Scorpio goes, shh, I'm not going to interrupt. But they can be in the room. So if someone has this in their own chart, they have a great gift with being quiet. It's something that many people don't know how to do. But when you're double water, you feel self-conscious because other people are always talking and you don't really want to speak. And in astrology, what you learn is that's nothing's wrong. That's normal for you. For you to be the witness or be the observer or be the one that's listening, which is what Pisces Scorpio does best, doesn't mean that you're shy or you're inadequate socially. It means you're deep and you're sensitive. Well, here's the good news. On the 3rd, that would be Wednesday, Mars enters Gemini. So for this baby who's being born, they've got that gentle energy, but Mars enters Gemini and gives them the gift of words. So there's a beautiful relationship between the moon in Scorpio trining the sun and that stellium in Pisces. There's sun, Venus, and Neptune all hanging out together. That's very sweet and gentle and fluid and soft. Now, we have Uranus in Taurus is opposite the moon in Scorpio, and it's squaring Saturn, Jupiter, and Mercury in Aquarius. So look at that. That's a T-square. You've learned this before. When Uranus is opposite the moon, when any two planets are opposite each other, and the third planet's 90 degrees, see the capital T? And it all releases in Leo. So Pisces Scorpio would just hate this. If a baby were born and had the sensitivity and their chart had a T-square in it and released in Leo, and I would say to them, you must be an actress or an actor. That's what Pisces Scorpio are built for. Let yourself release the boundary and let your emotional body be open. And that's what actors and actresses do. They give us permission to feel. And the release of the whole chart was Leo, and Mars had entered Gemini. They'd be great communicators. This is how astrology works. We look at the chart, and we can tell the propensity or the style of this being and help the parents let their children be who they really are. Yeah, I love astrology and children. Okay, so if you want your child's chart done, you can write to DebraSilvermanAstrology.com, and I will fix up an astrologer who specializes in children to look at your chart, because there's nothing more important to me. Okay, Wednesday and Thursday, Pisces, Scorpio, we're just going to flow here. Astrology answers wanted me to end this by saying, give yourself permission when the moon's in Scorpio and the sun's in Pisces to be quiet. No guilt. I'm giving you a guilt, get out of free jail card that says, if you don't want to talk, you don't have to. If you like this video, then be sure to join the waiting list for my online school, Applied Astrology. That's where you get to discover the basics of how to read your birth chart, how to give readings to others, your true purpose in this lifetime, and a clear roadmap to follow your path right to falling in love with you. You. Click the link in the description to join the waitlist, and I'll let you know first when the registration opens.